Hey guys, it's finally here! Meng's beautiful FA-18E kit. So let's bust this bad boy open and see what's inside. Hey guys, welcome back. So today we're going to look at hotly anticipated Hornet from Super Hornet from Meng, and this is the E version. So we've all been waiting a very long time for a new one. Hasegawa brought their version out, which was good in its day, but this is 2005, so this is 16 years old now. So it's about time you have a newly tooled version of this very popular and very, you know, very well used around the world aircraft. So a little bit of housekeeping, there's going to be a few different versions. This first video I'm doing right here is simple, kind of looking through the box, seeing what we got. I'm also going to do a video where I compare this one to the Hasegawa one I just showed you. So we'll do a comparison between the two, the Hornet, the Meng versus the Hase, and see which, you know, any major differences. And then also I'm actually going to do a build series on my channel. So I'm wrapping up my F-15C right now. I think I have a part or two left. But literally as soon as I've done editing and doing these videos later today, I'm going to actually start building this immediately. I'm going to film it and do a full build series of about 6 to 8 parts on my channel, which will go up every Friday, as always, once the F-15 is finished. So that out of the way, let's go ahead and get started looking through the box. I tried to make this as brief as possible. I'm not going to spend hours going through the instructions. As always, if you guys want to look at it in more detail, just pause it and you can read it in your own time. So, going through the box, looks like we have the Golden Warrior markings. On the other side, we have the beautiful markings on this side. The VFA-31, sorry. And also, when we open this up, I'm pretty sure they have the Top Gun markings too. So Pete Mitchell's Top Gun 2 markings. I'm assuming they didn't put it on the side of the box because they probably don't have the licensing from Paramount Pictures or the approvals. That's probably why, Meng being a Chinese company, that's probably why they just kind of threw them in the box. But we'll see when we go through this. So again, 40x scale. Just talk real quick about price. So I bought this from Lucky Model in Hong Kong because as the time of recording this, they're not out in North America or Europe yet. Lucky Model wasn't badly priced. It was priced at $49.95 US dollars, and shipping was a little bit high for express shipping. It cost about $18, I believe, in shipping. I did have a coupon where if you spent over $50, you get 10% off. So the obviously prices are $49.95. So I literally added one roll of masking tape to get my $5 off. So I think it worked out about, in the end, about $64 shipped to US. Hasegawa goes for about $60-$65 all day long, always has been. So we're about the same price range as that. I was hoping to get this a couple of weeks earlier, to be honest with you. I ordered it a while back when it released, and then I think with China, it shipped out, and I think it got stuck for a week with Chinese New Year, and then obviously pandemic, and then some ice storms and some bad weather here in the US. It kind of delayed it a little bit. So I was hoping to just get out of my channel a couple of weeks earlier, but like I said, this literally just arrived through the door like half an hour ago, so I'm immediately getting to this. So I've not opened the box at all, so I'm going to open it now for the first time and take a look what we've got inside. Okay, so we're greeted with quite a lot of plastic. So I'm going to just take all of this out. And we're going to take a look at it in a minute. Looks like we've got some little bag of screws. Off the bat, the plastic's looking really nice, just kind of glancing at this. Again, let's kind of get all of this out of the box and we'll start. Decals, and there we go. A little bag here. What's going on? So I apologize for rustling, which will take place because these bags are kind of crinkly. The good thing is, though, as I mentioned, I'm going to build this right away, so there's no point in me putting all the stuff back in a bag, so it makes things a little bit easier. Okay, so we got this kind of very nice kind of cardboard. Looks like a hole punch you can put in the binder. So this is obviously in Chinese. We've got like a Russian version. And English. So actually, 1, 2, 3. So we have like three cardboard, kind of nice little touch. So you have a little bit of that Super Hornet. I guess you just scroll through your languages. So what, about three or four paragraphs in the various languages. So it looks like we go through Chinese, Mandarin, to English, to... Sorry, my ignorance. Maybe that's Japanese. I'm not quite sure. I'm in Russian. No Spanish, though. Anyway, so just a quick little kind of thing, fact sheet about the aircraft. I've seen a couple of kits like this, I think, in the past. Very nice kind of thick cardboard. And we've got the instructions. Nice glossy color. Now, the main rig stepped it up recently. Since they did the Wing Not Wings one, they kind of really updated their instructions, but what color and stuff. So let's go through this and see what we've got in the instructions.
Let's move this guy out of the way a little bit.
So again, it's really nice paper. So it looks like first part, we start with a cockpit tub. Looks like we have a lot of decals for the instruments, which is really cool. I like that. And going through, this is kind of how all kind of Hornets go together. You do, then you're going to have the front wheel bay underneath the cockpit tub and sandwich it in the front section. But it's nice how, you know, it's colored, the parts you add is all colored, easy to follow. And just following through the instructions. You see it looks like the wings are separate, so you can do wings folded up or down. Very cool. Intakes, two-piece intakes. Okay, main landing gear bay. Again, if you just want to look at it slow, just pause it. If any adding side parts of the fuselage on. Again, following these instructions, it's really nicely laid out because, see, it's very simple. There's only two or three parts added to each section. It's not crazy, kind of in your face, kind of lots of stuff going on. So it's very nice to follow, especially if you're a beginner. And adding polycaps for the stabilizers. Then HUD. Flaps. Looks like you can have the flaps retracted. So it looks like you have them up or down the flaps and slats. That's the flaps extended. Wait, okay, now the wings, you can have it unfolded, which is this section right here. Again, real nice, clear, concise instructions. Very good, easy to follow. And option flaps retracted or extended. And more work on the wings, the flaps, wing fences. Tails and the exhaust nozzles. And step 14, kind of bring it all together. I always paint and weather these separately at the very end. Just a little PVA glue or super glue, add these on. Makes it a lot easier than having to do it all. But stabilizing the tails makes it a lot easier than having to do it all when it's all fixed. Then it's like very detailed gear. See that right there? CAD. Okay, it looks like one piece wheels. And front landing gear. Or maybe not, I'll take that back. Wait. Oh, that's a nose. Okay, so I'm sorry, no, that's a nose gear, one wheel, and then now in main gear. Obviously, two pieces for the wheels. Okay, now we're moving on to the pylons, fuel tanks, and GBU 24s and 16s. Looks like we have two of each. We have an A9X. We have two of those. We have three AIM-120Cs, AIM-9M2, an AN-ASQ pod 228, sorry. Excuse me, I'm butchering this. If you're US Navy or anything, I apologize, I'm butchering all this stuff. But let's go along and adding the pylons, the stores, and mounting positions. So there's a lot of different options here. And seat. I'll say seats, but only one seat, obviously being the E version. Okay. And then you get a pilot figure with this too. Cool. So canopy. Well, the framing goes in the canopy. We have a pilot figure, which I think looks pretty well detailed from what I saw in the CAD drawings. And then adding the seat and the pilot and the canopy on at the very end. And an aerial antenna, sorry. We have a boarding ladder. You want to go that route. Boarding ladder down, out, deployed. We can have it closed up. Well, we got painting masks too, I guess. Oh, this is pretty cool. So here's just the layout of all the different sprues you got. Nothing special there. It looks like we have a painting mask. So it shows you have the mask for the wheels. I always just use the circle templates, paint the whole thing rubber black, put a circle template like the kids have, drawing circles over it, and just spray the middle white or whatever color the aircraft you're doing. So we have masking and we have a canopy mask too, which is really cool. We'll be interested to see if these are die cut or not. Like Tamiya don't normally cut them, so you have to cut it yourself. So we'll see what we've got in this one. But that saves you another, you know, $8-$10 having to buy a mask set. And the markings. Okay, what we've got going on here. So we got the VFA 31. Looks like both of these. So quite a lot. So both of these pages are the same. So you get both sides. And then you get the looking down and the bottom. Number A. B we got. We got here the golden. Oh no, B is the low vis VFA 31. You want to go low vis version? A little bit plainer. Actually, I got a really. If I remember, I put it up here, but I got a picture of a really good. Of it. I think it's a Super Hornet. It might be a Lexi Hornet going through the Mac loop in the UK, and it's just weathered up really, really nicely, and it make it. If you replicate on a model, it'll look awesome. If I remember, I'll put a picture up. But if you do something plain like this, you could really go to town with weathering. If I remember, I'll put a picture up to show you guys the Mac loop picture. C is the Golden Warriors, more of a low vis again. Okay, and then what have we got? One more left. D is what I think it is. It is. It's Pilot Unknown. Okay, well, we all know it's Pete Mitchell. It's the Navy Strike Fighter Tactical Instructor Program 2019. No reference to Top Gun here, but I tell you that that is a Top Gun aircraft, and I'm not sure how well we can zoom in there, but that decal does say Pete Mitchell. So that this is the Top Gun 2. Obviously, it's unlicensed. Paramount Pictures didn't sign off on it, but Meng have included, nicely included it. So I think I might do this one. I know it's got some nice markings on it. It's not completely plain, and plus it's Top Gun. Who doesn't like Top Gun, right? So that's this guy, number D. Yeah, pretty cool. So got that black spine with a stripe, and then markings and decals and colors and stuff for the weapons, and the fuel tanks and stuff. Colors at the back, they use an AK, and looks like guns at Acrius. But it's the usual stuff. I mean, you're just going to be light and dark ghost gray, dark gold gray for the cockpit, and then just whatever, you know, the usual top, the greens and blacks and stuff. But if you want to take a look at colors, there you go. And that is it. I mean, I'm really impressed so far with the instructions. That's really nicely laid out. Cool instructions, and as expected, we got a Top Gun one, so cool. So that's it. Let's look at the decals. And I see a little bit of photo etch in there too, which I didn't spot in the instructions. Staples and all these guys, so bear with me. Just kind of break my way through. Oh, one thing I should note too is, if you think about building this, I got this right here. Reed Air Publications, the Super Hornet book. This is an amazing book. All these pictures. If you're ever building one in the cockpit, all over the aircraft. They did a first edition a few years ago. Now, they don't do a limited number of these books. It came out, and no joke, they'll go on eBay for like $300. I saw one for $600. I'm not sure anyone ever paid $600 for this book. It's a $35 book. So these can get really hard to find. So if you think about building one, Reed Air Publications, Model Super Hornet Guide. So again, edition one, which this is edition two, sold out, and it's really expensive to buy on the second-hand market. This is edition two, which just came out. I'm filming this at the end of February 2021. This came out at bound about, I think, December 2020 or January 21 was when he brought out the second edition. So it's the same book, but more pictures added, which is actually better. And again, you can buy it straight from Reed Publications, about $30, $35. They do some great books. I've got the F-15, I've got the 16, I've got the 14. I got a bunch of different of these books. But again, if you're a model builder and you build a few of these guys, it's just the level of detail in these books is amazing. Just help you reference pictures and stuff. You can get the stuff off the internet, but just having the book makes it so much easier. So yeah, it's highly recommend. It's a plug for this one. So again, Reed Air Publications, you can Google it, and this is the Modern Super Hornet book. If you want the ISBN number, it's right there. Cool. All right, back to this guy. So looks like we got a few different decals. Oh, we've got the Mars set, which actually isn't like the usual like yellow kabuki paper. It's actually plasticky vinyl. And it is die cut. Very cool. So we've got a Mars set. And these decals are printed by Cartograph, which is awesome because they're the best people at making decals. Got this little one right here. This looks like my profile of weapons. The ordnance. We have very thin photo etch. Looks like we have the first compressor blades, exhaust nozzle, and some kind of vent panel maybe. Yeah, excuse my ignorance, I'm not an expert in Hornet or any aircraft. And really big, vibrant color. Now, the followers of my channel know I'm coming ranting recently about Edward. Edward used to do beautiful decals made by Cartograph. Man, they brought them in-house, saved money, and they're crap. Meng, I've used Cartograph for these, and they're beautiful. I'm just looking at them right now. The color's so vibrant. In register. And I'm searching around for names here, if I can find that elusive Pete Mitchell. You don't see it. Huh. Sorry, I'm just glancing through this real quick. Or maybe it doesn't have... Oh, there it is. I read the bottom there. Look at that. Why are we on the camera? Do-do-do-do. Captain, still a captain. Pete Mitchell, Maverick. Well, actually, no, my bad. I'm actually thinking of it. This is Navy ranks, right? So, captain, is he what I'm thinking of, like Air Force ranks, captain? So, that's right. So he's a captain. Made his way to captain. I think he was, I can't remember what he was in Top Gun 1. Was he like a lieutenant commander or something? Somebody can sure correct me in the comments below. But yeah, all these markings are beautiful. Yeah, no problems at all. Cartograph, so you know it's going to go down well. Even tiny little guys right here. You can make out all the words pretty much. Some of these you can't really, a little bit blurry, but I mean, they're tiny. No step you can make out quite clearly in person. And there you go. Really nice decal set. All right, time to get in the plastic. Let me kind of get this stuff out of the way. And let's start with the big boys first. Now, this is off the bat, it's really nice plastic. Looking here as well, nice detail. It doesn't look too overdone. I think once you've got paint and primer, it's going to be fine for this scale. I'm sure bringing out probably an F version too. It's normally how it works, if you can kind of catch that in the light. The wings. Very nice. Ejection pins. On the inside, but not going to interfere with anything. But really nice solid piece of plastic. On the other side, we've got a bunch of poly caps. And the nice thing about this too, I'm looking around, there's no kind of attachment points. Normally you have like bits of chunks hanging up, you have to clean up and stuff, but I don't see any on here. Or maybe a little bit there, clean up right there, but overall it looks, again, solid piece of plastic. So we kind of sandwich it together a little bit. Needs a little bit something to it, add it to strength, but you can get your idea of where we're at. Cool. What next? There's so much plastic here. So we've all got 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 big sprues, and then about like another 6 to 10 smaller ones. I'm just really excited about this. I can't wait. So I say, as soon as I finish this video, I'm going to start building this cockpit right away and start assembling this guy. Wings. That you're going to fold it up or down, however you want it. Again, really nicely detailed. No problems, no flash. Nice and clean molded. Very nice. Okay, this next one is a match pair. So you got your stabilizer and your fuel tanks. And a couple of years ago, I went to the Oceania Air Force show, Oceania Air Show. I didn't realize it was the home of the Hornet or whatever. I mean, there's so many. I literally remember when I drove into the air show, these fuel tanks were just like boxes of them, pallets of them, just lined up. There's probably dozens, hundreds of them, and they're just really, really kind of crappy looking. So, I mean, you really go to town weathering these things. I think I have some pictures and stuff like that too, but I mean, they just look so crap, like dinged up and rusty and messed up and kind of stuff. So, looking at the wheel, really nice detail. Fan blade's not too bad. Looks like we have some arms for a pilot. We have three arms, so I'm guessing you can probably choose which kind of position you want to do. Unless for some reason the pilot has three arms, which would be kind of weird. Pylons have really nice detail. This is going to really pick out nicely in the wash. With the wash. And there's your pilot. Just trying to figure out which way his head down it goes around. I think it's that way around. Wait, where is it? So you have the mask on and the mask off. Again, this is the match pair. We have two of these. Pretty nicely detailed. Exhaust nozzles. A little bit plain, but they always are on these kind of kits, right? It's with the Hornet. Okay, again, really nice, nice and clean, crisp. So two of those. Cockpit tub. That looks really nice. So you got the buttons on the side here, raised. That'll take it really good for picking that out with a little bit of paint, or like a Posca marking pen or something. Again, nice detail around here. Very cool. Okay, looks like the next part is intakes and the wheel wells. big sprue.
So let me move some stuff out of the way so it's not in.
There we go. Really nicely detailed for out the box. Main wheels. Really nice and detailed. Oh, gear again. There's your intakes. Very cool. Okay, more fuselage. Front, sorry, the front part of the fuselage and the sides. Detail. This thing's gonna look so nice once it's got a wash on, and being the light and dark gross gray colors, it's gonna really can pick out like the dark dirt wash really well on this. Unlike if you're doing like a gunship gray or something, in that case it's kind of sometimes hard to see a wash, but this is gonna pick it out beautifully. Instrument panel, that's really nicely, very crisp, nicely done. Control stick. Very cool. Another beautiful sprue. Okay, I got one drop from the floor, so let me kind of reach down and grab that. Ugh. Okay, so you've got tails. Two-piece, nice and again crisp, beautifully molded, as always, but this kit seems to be like. And then we got the big flaps. Looks like I've got leading edges and various other parts right here too. No problem at all. Zero flash. Again, no ejection pin marks. There are, but they're all kind of smoothed down. I know when I built Aang armor kits, sometimes you've got big gnarly bits sticking off. You have to kind of rub off your finger and sand down and stuff. No problem. Oh, anything. Do we talk about nose? I don't remember we talked about nose. The radome. Right.
Okay, now we're kind of moving to the weapons. So, first of all, we've got this little bag of screws. I'm just going to put in a box so I don't lose them. We've got, looks like these are the heads of the ordnance, the clear parts. Then, we've got going on here. Okay, so you've got three of these guys. One piece. Can't beat that. There's no one piece slide molded. Three of those guys. Looks like we've got more like seeker heads on lights, or some clear parts. Okay, these guys are two parts. Two of those. I'm just going to scroll back through instructions. Excuse my ignorance, I can tell you what exactly they are. So, this looks like a GBU. It's GLs, GLs. So these are the GBU 16s. This is SGM, so this is going to be GBU-24s we're about to look at. Again, this is two parts, but this is beautiful, it's plastic. So crisp. So GBU-24s. Two of those.
SMJ, which is going to be... your AIM-9X is two of those. Again, one piece slide molded, beautiful. No problems at all. We can't really sport from weapons nowadays, ordnance. I mean, AMK brought out a really nice set with F-14 of up-to-date ordnance. These are really nice. Trick Real Hobbies produced amazing one-piece slide molded too. Manufacturers really kind of stepping up where it used to be. So, pretty sure Hasegawa never used them. I'm pretty sure in the Super Hornet kit they don't have any weapons. So, I'll check that out in a minute when I'm done with this one. But so, this is SMI, which is, what are we up to? This is AIM-9M. So this is one piece in the set, but then you got the fins. Two of those. Last but not least, clear parts. Whew, a lot of stuff in this. I'm just glad I have to put it all back in the bags again. It's like I say, I'm gonna build this one, so. Okay, so it's in like saran wrap or something like that. Clear saran wrap. It looks really clear. To be honest, I don't want to take this out because I don't want to damage it or anything, because I want to save it for when I build it. But I can just tell by looking for the plastic here, if I pull a bit back, it looks really clear. It looks like a slight tint on it. It's not quite clear. There's like a slight tint, which I'm not sure is real or not. There's rivets all the way around the side, but that looks really nice. And then this is the front section. Again, I'm surrounded with this kind of sticky saran wrap. So I don't want to take all this off. I'm just going to leave it. We've got the front, the windshield, and so it looks like some lights and stuff here too. But yeah, it looks all really nice. I can just tell by looking, even looking for the plastic, it's super clear. No distortion or anything. Whew. And that is it. What a beautiful kit. I mean, say I'm a big fan of anything American, like from like 90s and early 2000s, even modern day stuff. So this is right in my wheelhouse. I'm really looking forward to this one. I'm glad I bought it for sure. Price point, I don't think it's that bad. You got the master set, you got all the weapons in it. Compared to what kits go for nowadays, I think it's about level, about par for the course. So yeah, beautiful FA-18E. So there you go. I'm not an expert in Hornets, so if I misspoke about stuff, and I apologize, but there you go. Hopefully you found that one interesting. It does have the Top Gun markings, like I said, Top Gun 2. I'm going ahead and I will be doing a build series of this one. Once I've finished up editing and stuff, I'll start immediately filming and building this and putting a multi-part series up on my channel. So if you haven't done so, please consider subscribing, liking, all that kind of stuff. And until next time, see you later. Goodbye.